it's strange in Russia that after communism, a lot of people have become publicly Christians again. My sense of the country as a whole is that Christian values are much more deeply embedded in a Russian psyche than, say, democratic values. I live in Moscow and I work teaching the Dharma, teaching meditation and Buddhism there. And I've been there 4 years, and a small Sangha is beginning to emerge now after a couple of years of classes. We don't have a centre. We rent rooms in a general spiritual centre for 3 classes a week. And as always with new classes, it's fairly small to begin with. Sometimes 1 or 2 or 3 people turn up, sometimes 6, 7 or 8. I think 9 has been our limit so far. It's been the biggest class. It's always quite a strange experience. You arrive in a new city, you don't really know anybody. On the first day, I looked at the map of Moscow and I decided, well, what's the most interesting part? And I took a metro to somewhere in the centre and I walked up and down for a few hours and had a look around. On the second day, I chose another place and then I walked around and walked up and down. I quite quickly got a sense that the second place, which is called Chisti Prudi, was somewhere I felt at home in. It was quite central, quite cosmopolitan, but also more relaxed. When I was living in Paris beforehand, I developed a habit of reading a book in a bar at the end of the day. And I carried on when I arrived in Moscow. And one of those evenings, a young woman, she noticed I was reading a book on Buddhism. And she asked me about it and found out that I was a member of the Triratna Buddhist Order. And said that if I wanted to teach, she had worked at a place that I could hold classes at. She gave me the address of somebody to talk to, which actually helps a lot. In Russia, things operate a lot on the basis of personal connections. So if you know somebody in advance, it's a lot easier than just turning up. I started living in a small hostel where other tourists, sometimes Russian people, would come and stay, usually for a few days. The owner was a woman called Galina, and she had a flat with 3 bedrooms. And she lived in 1 room with her husband, and there was a 3rd room with 5 beds. And I lived in the 3rd room. I had a bed there. There was a couple of wardrobes that I used. I put my books on top of the wardrobe. It became a bit of an unofficial bookshelf because all the bookshelves were used. And it fits with the anagarika lifestyle, being homeless and not having my own place, which means it's a lot less expensive. It means my resources, my time, can be much more dedicated to Dharma work and or having time to reflect, do nothing, read, meditate. I was originally born in Russia. It was always, in a way, on the cards that I'd go back, although it wasn't always obvious to me. It was almost like I had a Russian internal conditioning and I needed to operate within a context, an objective Russian set of conditionings to understand myself more deeply. The Russian language is very different to English. In Russian, way of thinking is very different to English. It feels that I'm getting to know myself more deeply and I have noticed that it has meant that I can more fully communicate myself both in Russia and with other people outside Russia. The personal side of it, of me going back to Russia, is very closely linked with the side of wanting to do it to establish the Dharma there. It's certainly a help for us that Buddhism has been established for so long. The Gelug school of Tibetan Buddhism, monks from that tradition started teaching 400 years ago in Siberia. So now there's 3 Buddhist republics. When people meditate together, there's quite a strong communication. So I feel that the meditation practices that I've done for 20, 22 years, I share the fruits of those with people who are meditating with me maybe for the first time. there was a big step about 4 or 5 months ago when the person who became our first mitra, Jena, she asked for ordination. So that was a big step in taking things, growing things a bit more than just having me as a Buddhist teacher.
Okay. Yeah. Sure.